Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Chelsea Bayarte. Just last month, a SpaceX cargo spacecraft made a delivery to the International Space Station. It brought more than 3 tons of food, supplies, scientific experiments to the astronauts living in orbit. But what comes up must come down, and the Dragon spacecraft is set to return to Earth next week, but it won't come back empty-handed. This is NASA's SpaceX 32nd cargo resupply mission. Now that it's at the end of its mission, the astronauts will spend this week loading it up with items so that the spacecraft can return cargo back to Earth. So, what's coming home? Dragon is bringing books back from space. These books were part of Storytime from Space, where an astronaut reads children's books, recorded on video, that can be watched at home or in the classroom. But don't worry, plenty of books remain aboard the space station that the astronauts can read in their spare time. Another passenger on the ride home is hardware from Astro B Reach. The Astro B robot used arm attachments to catch floating items. The technology demonstration successfully showed its ability to grab onto objects and relocate them aboard the space station. One day, technology like this can be used on a larger scale, grabbing onto orbital debris in low Earth orbit. NASA astronaut Johnny Kim recently showed off a creative way that he's using goodies from the cargo delivery that he received. Johnny said that he enjoys cooking and recently tried out a new bite-sized burger recipe. He used wheat snacks as bread, beef steaks, potatoes au gratin, cheese spread to hold everything together and keep it from floating apart, and some spicy red pepper paste to top it all off. When astronauts are aboard the International Space Station, they spend most of their day working on scientific experiments. Microgravity allows us to do science in ways that aren't possible on Earth. One field that might benefit from the microgravity environment is that of cancer research, helping find treatments for people back on Earth. In space, cells grow into 3D shapes that behave much like they do in the body. These conditions make it possible to study mechanisms and pathways that control growth and function of cancer-related cells in ways that researchers just can't do back on Earth. For example, protein crystals grown in microgravity produce larger, more uniformed crystals that researchers can use to see details about its structure that could lead to targeted treatments. One experiment conducted on the space station just this week is called ADCEP-ICC. It expands on one of the space station's current protein crystallization facilities, allowing astronauts to process even more sample types, including tiny gold particles used in cancer detection and targeted drug delivery systems. To follow along with continued cancer research on station and to learn more about science coming home next week on a cargo spacecraft, check out ISS_research on social media and on NASA.gov. That's it for Space to Ground this week. Thanks for watching.